Oh, wait. I gotta play that Jets nigga, bro. Oh my gosh.
Talk about Reggie?
Yes, bro. I beat him the last three times we played. I don't know how I did, but.
I was supposed to play Joshua.
I'm so sick of playing this nigga, baby, bro. I'm gonna see him on a conference championship too, bro. I just know I am.
No, you don't see me.
Bro, you're not that nice.
Dude, I put Joshua in a mixer. I had him boxed up in my sockets. He was lost.
Joshua.
The nigga that wanted Drake London for me.
Oh, you talking about, okay.
Yeah, he was. I had him packed up in the Falcons. I started running some new defense. Yes, sir.
Told you, bro.
Got me new defense.
Oh, that's gay.
All right, bitch.
That's gay.
At Lincoln Financial Field in South Philly. Tonight we wrap up an intriguing week two with a good Monday night matchup between the Minnesota Vikings and the Philadelphia Eagles. The final weekend of the summer. Hope you're enjoying it wherever you are as we are off and running on EA Sports. Kenny Nwangu now out of his end zone. And he had no room to run as his tackle left the right side of the track.
And he's going to be taken down. Cousins. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked up by Eli Apple. And the Eagles are going to take possession of the football as they force the turnover on the ground. So this is something we didn't see at all from this offense in the control last week. That's a turnover.
Exactly what you stated. Didn't see it last week, but it's a key to their win. And it'll be a key to this game as well. Protecting the football. Didn't get it done there.
They'll throw on first down with Hurts. And he can't find anyone to go with him. And he goes down.
By Daniel Hunter. It's a loss of two. Brings up second and 12. At the 25-yard line.
Strength of late. They know how to get after the quarterback.
Absolutely. Four sacks last week. That's their first one here. Anything in particular you've seen from them or on film?
I think that they're winning athletically up front, winning those one-on-one battles. But also, when the offensive line wants to keep everyone in and mass protect, they know how to scheme to get back to the quarterback as well.
And nothing doing on this time. But maybe gets it back to the line of scrimmage with the season opening victory.
And how'd you like to be the quarterback reviewing the game tape from last week and seeing this defense on the spot on almost every snap? If the ball was in the air, they took it away. If the ball was popped free, they picked it up. Five takeaways in last week's game.
Now a pass hauled in downfield.
Behind them, you can see the hours of practice that have gone into it. Great pocket by the running back. Quarterback puts it right in the perfect spot. Great mesh play by them. The timing, the run, even better.
On second and 10, Hurts. Hurts fumbles it, and the Vikings pick up the football. And the return goes up to his own 17-yard line. And I guess we're back to square one. Rocky Rocky starting to return his own turnover.
Not exactly what we expected going into the game, but I always wonder about the nerves, the people starting, the emotions of the game. Sometimes it takes a little while for that to play out, for them to settle in. It's hopefully that's taken care of.
He's brought down at the 20-yard line. A 3-yard pickup brings up 7-7.
Seven, Cousins. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back in the
11-yard. And it's third down.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Open man here is Cole. And he'll have this pass the 30 prior to going out of bounds.
Complete to number 13.
The defense shaking their heads, not aggressive enough for the line to convert.
And the Vikings are down.
Play action now, Cousins. He's going to find Jefferson open downfield. And he's going to be out of bounds right at midfield.
Justin Jefferson.
Yards of movement with those last 19
yards. First down, Vikings.
Cousins now from the 50. This will be caught by his big wide receiver. And he'll get this to the 30-yard line
Cousins
before
pass,
crossing over out
complete
of bounds.
To number 13.
That one good for 20.
It's
another catch
of 20.
And that last
first
for Charles
down,
is going to move him past 32,942 yards passing for his career. And that surpasses the total of the Hall of Famer and a colleague of both of ours, Troy Aikman.
Yeah, played from 1989 to 2000. And Troy Aikman, he was about winning. Because remember, he had Michael Irvin to throw it to.
And Emmitt Smith to hand it to him.
The Vikings with the football here to begin the second quarter, as they've got it with a first and 10. Cousins to throw it. And he's going to be taken down. Fisher gets there back at the 49 yard line.
A 10-yard loss on the play. It's second down.
Throwing on second and long. Cousins. And this one is in.
Cousins pass. Intended for Justin Jefferson. Incomplete. A fun tag magic on the cover.
They tried to get it all back on that one. Weren't able to do so.
A long way to go here on third down for the eighth play of the drive. Cousins. And he's got this to Jefferson. And he has another first down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 12-yard line. Third down, good for 28-yard
gain.
Such a good round.
And the Vikings are
third down. Very efficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go.
Touchdown, Vikings! T.J. Hockenson, his third touchdown now on the year.
Touchdown,
and the Vikings post the first place.
Joseph on reporting for play.
The second quarter. Joseph connects.
The kick is good.
And that makes
the score
7-0.
Vikings 7, Eagles nothing.
Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he'll be stopped up at the
20. The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Set to go. They had the fumble on the last drive, wound up leading to the opening touchdown. Now they'll try again here, first and 10.
He operates well in the ball area. He was taken down behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard. It brings up second and 11 at the 24-yard line.
19 tight. Go.
Here's Hurts to throw. Brought down on the 30-yard line.
Keeper, Lewis C. On the
play to move the sticks.
It's a game of six. Brings up third and five.
They find some open field here. And able to get this one across the
field. Leon Briggs Smith. It's a game of 18. That's good. For an Eagles first down.
Hurt sets up to throw it. He's going deep for Brown. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by a Cam of Evans. And the
Hurts
Vikings are going to get the football.
Intercepted
the
by the Vikings.
The
they'll take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Last week it was interception after interception, and here we go again.
We actually quit counting last week at a certain point because I thought I was going to run out of fingers, right? Because I'm not all that skilled as a mathematician. But you're right, it felt like a
intended for Justin Jefferson. Incomplete. Brings up second and 10 at the 20-yard line.
Anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Again from the 20 after the incompletion. Here's second and 10.
Hey, Steven.
Throwing. Cousins. This one brought in by Jefferson. And he takes us beyond the 35
before to Justin Jefferson. It's a gain of 17 yards.
He's got a first down.
First down Viking.
Cousins gives way to Cook. Tight end Hockenson, and he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A big pickup of 38, working with the lead, trying to get to 2-0. Here's first and 10.
Yellow, yellow, yellow. Yellow, yellow, yellow. Mark, mark. I'm going.
To throw his Cousins. Steps away to his left. And he wisely will throw that one away.
So it looks like they stopped some fighting them on this series because it seemed like things were headed for the red zone. But if this defense gets two more stops, they can keep them out of that area.
Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. To throw, Cousins. Catch is made by Hockenson, the tight end. And they've got this down to about the 12-yard line.
Pass, complete.
Another good completion on the drive as the Vikings have a first down.
A gain of 14. First down, Minnesota.
2 minutes on the clock, second quarter, 7-0 ball game. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Cousins again. And his throw is
incomplete.
Keep possession of the football. Two drives, two turnovers to this point.
You're exactly right, Doctor. Hippocratic oath. First, do no harm. And right now, they're harming themselves on offense.
I like that. No one is mistaken. Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. So, nice play defensively
by the Vikings. They'll take over first down 10 at the 20-yard line.
End up winding up on special teams and sub packages and even on the practice goal. But he's really made an impact on this defense, and he comes up with the interception there.
Complete. Jefferson the target. And he'll get into the end zone.
Touchdown. Justin Jefferson.
Justin Jefferson.
Touchdown.
A 20-yard touchdown. And the Vikings will extend their lead in the final minute of the half.
Makes the score.
Joseph connects on the extra point.
Eagles,
and it's now 14-0. Now Joseph tees it up to kick off for the touchdown. Taken in at the 3. And taken down just past the 20.
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 21-yard line.
Philly offense set to go. Charles, you're down multiple scores, less than a minute left here, but with that deficit, they've got to try to at least work their way into field goal range to try to muster something out of this drive.
And I'm going to go ahead and date myself one more time because I'm going to quote it. First pass,
intended for A.J. Brown,
but they still have
makes
time.
It second and 10 at the 21-yard line.
Let's see if he gets a point out of it.
From the 21, it's second and 10.
18 Rattler.
Throwing is Hurts. He's going deep for Brown. And that will be incomplete. Trying to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
There is something to a game plan with trying to keep a defense honest with a guy with that type of speed. You do so. Send him deep. Try and throw some air under it and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they were unsuccessful.
And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
Jalen Hurts.
He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. Fielded at the 20. A good kick that
today
time.
Today, you love your on the return. The Vikings take over first and 10 at their own 35-yard line.
Vikings now to start their next drive. Already enjoying a two-score lead here late in the second quarter. Not a ton of time left. We'll see if they can work this at least into field goal range and try to get three.
Justin Jefferson.
13-yard gain there.
A gain of 14. First down, Vikings.
A first down throw for Cousins. He'll get this complete to Jalen Reagor. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over the
Ranger.
Now the Vikings will use the second
yards.
And the timeouts.
And the Vikings
14 seconds to go in this first half. First down, here's the run with Cook. And he'll go down here.
Now the 12. The Viking ball carrier. Taken down by the 12
seconds to go before halftime.
4 yards on the big sounds
because they
can take down.
Shotgun, and they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
To throw on second and six, Cousins quickly to Hockenson. Driving for the goal line, but he's marked down short. And with no timeouts,
that's
no chance
the end
to get the
first down. With the score, the Vikings 14. The Eagles nothing.
This first half will come to a close. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number three.
Greg Joseph to kick off for Minnesota.
It's the Eagles ready to see the football first, and they trail here as we resume action in this third quarter. Now this is going to be a return from the back line of the end zone.
Rashad Penny on the return. The Eagles take over first and 10. At their own 19-yard line.
To begin the next drive. By no means, certainly, are they out of this contest. Two-score game, start of the third quarter. But you feel like if they don't get points and then they give up points, this feels like an important
possession.
A loss of two brings up second and 12 at the 16-yard line.
You need some kind of points here, even if it's just a field goal. It's what I call one of those calming drives. Try and slow things down a little bit.
First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12.
Go!
And he's going to lose yardage here back to
the
12.
Smith, the ball carrier.
That's going to go down as a loss of
taken
five.
Down. Back in the 12-yard line.
Off the play fake. Here's Hurts rolling to his right. One but incomplete.
Hurts on the keeper.
Trying to figure out some strategy to get things
going.
Incomplete.
He's just trying to spark his team here to begin the third quarter. Not a lot going on that play, though.
That's pulled in at the 32. We'll call that a punt of 54.
The Vikings take over first and 10. At their own 38-yard line.
Start their next drive. Play fake. Cousins. And that's caught inside the 35. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30.
Jalen Ringer. A gain of 31 yards.
So the big first play changes the direction of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. A throw there, but that's going to end up incomplete.
Intended for Jalen Ringer. Incomplete.
In the third quarter. He's had a pretty good game to
him.
This certainly has, and it's not exactly the point where we're doing 4-minute offense yet. But they've got to think about milking the clock, but understanding clock management here on out.
Meanwhile, Cousins' throw pulled in by Jefferson.
Complete to Justin Jefferson. 5 yards on the play. And it's third down.
Because often it can get jumped, and that can turn into either an incompletion or an interception. But not on that one. Everything came together, and he catches it and goes over the sideline.
How about this? They'll try the option. Left side. And he will slide to a stop.
Cousins
he
does on the keeper.
First down. It's an 8-yard pickup.
And 8-yard pickup. First down Vikings.
This offense really looking polished those first couple of weeks. Here's first and 10. From the red zone now. Cousins. And it's caught in the end zone for the Viking touchdown by Justin Jefferson.
Justin Jefferson. Touchdown, Minnesota.
Second touchdown of the game, his third on the year. And
his
the Vikings take a three-touchdown lead.
Makes the score Vikings 21, Eagles 9.
And that makes the score
Greg Joseph to kick off for Minnesota.
Teams up to kick off following the touchdown.
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation. But they also understand they've got to move the ball. They've got to move the ball. In addition, they need to save as much time so they can get to the possessions.
First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
But first down, Hurts. He's going deep for Brown. It's caught at the 10.
That is able to work it out. Brown.
A big
it's
play.
A gain of 55.
55 yards.
That's good for an Eagles.
Hurts. And this is caught. Touchdown.
Special teams
the kick is
to
good.
To bring it out of the end zone.
But let's
makes
be honest,
score,
a lot of times
Vikings,
they bring it out of the end zone like he did.
Eagles,
they don't
seven,
have to. I mean, I think a lot of times they do, but correct me if I'm wrong. Sometimes it's just a guy getting
a favor.
You're exactly right. What's the old adage? Sometimes you just have to know when to break the rules. And if you do, you're taking on some responsibility. But he was happy to do so there.
Here comes the return from the very back of the end zone. And only able to get this to
Rashad
the 19.
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
Set to begin their next drive.
Buffalo,
this has been a tough one for them, Charles. They've struggled really on both sides of the football. And one thing that's really plagued them, the turnovers. They've had issues keeping the football in their possession.
And every game that's ever been played, all coaches talk about taking care of the football and limiting turnovers. And in this one,
Hurts fumbles it. And the Vikings pick up the football. And he's got some space here. And they are going to bring this
touchdown
one back. It's
Minnesota.
A field return, a scoop and score for
Greg
the
Joseph
Vikings.
On 40 yards from the
Joseph now to have the PAT. And he's been a busy man.
The kick is good.
Now as he knocks another
makes
one
the score
to extend the lead.
35, Eagles 7. Greg Joseph to kick off for Minnesota.
So get it again following that fumble return for a score.
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. Well, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail-biter in this one, CD, and if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
Are you saying that you feel like people are starting
to think about the keeper intended for A.J. Brown, incomplete. It's now second and 10 at the 25-yard line.
If they can't score here.
Yeah, you're right about that because it has been pretty clear who the better team has been in this one. And in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout, let's just say it's been unusual.
And he'll the wide receiver to all carriers, Harrison Smith on the tackle. That's a gain of three. It's third and seven.
It can be even more effective when you run a lot of motion, and there's plenty of times you don't hand it off.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game.
Trap 60!
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And a throw there gonna be incomplete.
I'm getting the sense that this offense is getting close to a into the third quarter. And they've had plenty of opportunities to get in sync. That hasn't happened. They're looking for answers both on the sidelines and in the huddle looking at each other.
So a change of possession. The Vikings
take over first and 10 at their own 15-yard line.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. They're continuing to rock and roll. And at intermission, you know, maybe sometimes you hear after such a good first half of a letdown, but that's a good question.
What I remember most about being in those situations is exactly what you're talking about. It's a sense of satisfaction. You're like, we're doing really well. I remember one time someone saying, winning's fun, but so is playing really well. Why would we want to do otherwise? That was the message to keep the intensity up, to keep things going. And that's exactly what we're seeing from this team.
Got an open man finding Jefferson. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken
to Justin Jefferson.
In search of a short gain of 31 yards.
And the Vikings first down.
Cousins now to throw on first down. Got his tight end over the middle, T.J. Hockenson.
Cousins
he's going to get this all the way down inside
to
the
30. T.J. Hockenson.
Two jump plays
it's a gain of 23 yards.
And so
first down, Minnesota.
To the air again, it's Cousins. Oh, there's that man again, it's complete. And he'll get this to the
20.
The Vikings are on their way to a 2-0
start.
His kick is good.
Joseph connects.
Makes the score. Viking has 42. Eagles 7.
That big lead. Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. This will be fielded inside the 5. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25.
Rashad Penny on the return. The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive.
Alert! Alert!
Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this is pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things in this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds
and several turnovers,
you have to think that's going to be something that we'll discuss heavily in the
first
session.
For the Eagles, first down, 35-yard line.
DeAndre
went with the ball carrier. Byron Murphy on the tackle. A gain of 5 brings up 2nd and 5 at the 40-yard line. A gain of 10 yards. That's good for an Eagles. 1st and 10 at the 50-yard line.
Towards the end zone for Brown. And a penalty flag comes in as that one winds up incomplete, but the contact is going to move the ball well downfield.
Let's go now.
So now then, the penalty's got him set up with a 1st and goal. Swift gets into the end zone for an Eagle touchdown.
Sometimes you have those big offensive linemen come and have to report like they're eligible, but all they're doing is getting a good stance, blocking, and getting
the ball. Will set up for the two-point conversion.
Hurts will throw.
The attempt at a two-point conversion is no good. That keeps the score Vikings 42, Eagles 13.
Because a lot of teams want to throw the ball in this situation. This time,
Jake Elliott to kick off for Philadelphia.
Be the way to go.
With it moved up from the 3 to the 2, you would think maybe a few more attempts at running.
I think
the onside kick was recovered by the Vikings.
The ball will at least be the equal of throwing it in that situation.
Drop the ball carrier. Brought down back at the 25-yard line.
Throwing on 2nd and 14. Cousins. That'll be caught. Rager with it. And
Cousins
he's going
to
be taken down.
Complete to Jalen Rager. It's a gain of 17 yards. First down, Vikings.
Team has certainly followed through with that tonight. Just an absolute clinic, Charles, on offense here, and they don't seem to be done trying to drive that football.
Yeah, and continue your theme about one team enjoying it.
Cousins
one
pass
fan base is
intended for Justin Jefferson.
They might disagree with what they've seen. The
brings up
2nd and 10.
Good route
here.
Throwing again on 2nd and 10. Cousins. And that is incomplete.
Cousins pass intended for Jalen Rager. Incomplete.
It's downfield for the defense.
Third down tonight. They've been near perfect. 4 for 5 to this point. This is 3rd and 10.
Two.
Cousins escaping the pressure right. Nothing open downfield.
Cousins on the keeper.
Run
to the sideline and incomplete.
Sharp in this one. It's resulted in a lot of touchdowns.
Brent Joseph scored a Vikings field goal. A 45-yard attempt.
Involved on offense pretty happy.
happy because that gives them more chance. The Packers' stats have been about as far as they actually need. You and I are going to need to just run this clock out because this one,
Greg Joseph, to kick off for Minnesota.
Fielded just outside the goal line. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20.
On the return, the Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 21-yard line.
Ready at the line, this Philly offense set to go. As the offense begins another drive here, pretty simple, Charles. They want a carbon copy of what happened the last time out when they ended their drive in the end zone.
DeAndre squared the ball carrier.
Sounds pretty simple.
The tackle made at the 24-yard line. It's a pickup of three.
We don't just make adjustments at halftime if you're a good football team. You spend that time on the sideline, you study what's on the notes and the tablets, and you make those adjustments to prevent a repeat of the last drive. Series to series, the best teams, that's how they get it done.
Soon enough, whether those adjustments are enough defensively.
A 7-yard loss brings up third down.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. He's going deep for Brown. And that will be incomplete.
Hurts pass intended for A.J. Brown. Incomplete.
That's coming up. It's back to a tie game late. Not in a lopsided game like this. They are not letting up.
They're going on fourth down with Hurts. He's going deep for Brown. And Hurts is intercepted, his third of the game.
Hurts pass intercepted by the Vikings. They'll take over their
touch in this one, Charles turns to goal.
And they have to be awfully happy right there to get what appears to be one more for the road. It helps seal away.
And that's caught inside the 30.
Cousins pass complete to Jalen Reagor. A gain of 45 yards. And the Vikings first down.
On the sidelines at the end of the third quarter, doing the old hold up four fingers college sign, meaning the fourth quarter is ours. And they certainly weren't kidding.
First down, here's Cousins. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. The CD there up big, but they're still passing it. I mean, this is an offense that's had a lot of success in this game, and it seems like they're just having fun out there.
And it does feel like there's been a shift out there, doesn't it, partner? Listen, if you're up, you can continue to do what you want to do. It's up to the other team to make you change how you do things. They'll continue to throw it around until stopped.
A second down pass play there, but it's Cousins incomplete.
Cousins pass intended for Justin Jefferson.
Progressing the envelope later, but if any fail of these passes, it's after getting more aggressive to try to drive the ball downfield.
And that will certainly lend itself to some post-game questions for that coach, and maybe you and I should attend that press conference and see what he has to say, because someone's going to ask him why he continued to push it. My guess? He didn't like how some of the snaps were run earlier. He wanted to use that as a chance to clean things up.
Greg Joseph on for the field goal. A 43-yard attempt.
Joseph's got it. And that
the kick is good. Makes the score. Vikings 28, Eagles 13.
They take the three and they pad that lead.
Yeah, this one's already wrapped up, but you and I both know, if you're an offensive coordinator, you never let up on the gas unless the head coach tells you to do so. And maybe you've actually flipped him off in your headset so you can keep calling plays.
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Offense set to begin their next drive. CD, it's all window dressing at this point. And the best they can do is end the game with a nice drive to maybe build some momentum to move forward into their next contest.
Yeah, with how lopsided this game has been, even one score
intended for A.J. Brown. Incomplete. It's now second and 10 at the 25-yard line.
To focus on when you get back to practice in the next couple of days.
They'll try and set up the screen to Swift. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
Complete to DeAndre Swift.
It's safe to say defensively.
It's a gain of 5. Brings up 3rd and 5.
It's been very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You tackle them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Here's Hurts to throw. And unable to connect. Incomplete.
Hurts pass. Intended for A.J. Brown. Incomplete.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
Ready? Nothing, 19!
They'll try and throw for it with Hurts. Oh, hit as he throws, and this is going to be incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Vikings have a turnover on excellent field position. Cook now off the read option. And he's able to work his way down inside the red zone to the 19-yard line.
Taken down at the 19-yard line.
To start the drive, it's just about the length of the football.
First down, Minnesota.
And I think you and I were both raised the same way in the game of football. You run to set up the pass, but I think we've discovered in this NFL, a lot of teams pass to set up the run. And that's what they've done throughout this game. They've aired it out, thrown it around the yard. Now they've come back to the run game.
Cousins hands to Dalvin Cook. Taken down at the 11-yard line. A gain of 9 brings up 2nd and 1.
And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 and the 6.
The tackle made at the 6-yard line. 1st and goal at the 6-yard line.
With Cook, and they are going to score again.
Dalvin Cook on the carry. Touchdown, Minnesota. Greg Joseph on the 48th for play.
This one was over a while ago, so good. Just add on to their big lead.
The score, Vikings 55, Eagles 13.
Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. This is taken way up at the 25. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good
the
shape.
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 31-yard line.
This Philly offense set to go. This is just an exercise in futility. Do you even want to running a play here offensively?
I wouldn't, because now is not going to erase what's happened during the game. So after it's over, you can go to the film, find out where the game was really lost. But this is not a situation now where you're going to make up for anything.
We'll see what.